Hi, I'm Joe Average, and I'm going to put airbags and a wireless onboard air compressor on this truck.
And why do I need these? Because I pull a very heavy trailer in some pretty remote locations, and I need all the control I can get.
The airlift load lifters have been around for quite some time. They're excellent airbags, and they do really well. This 5000 Ultimate model adds an additional benefit of having internal jounce bumpers inside the spring. So when I remove the bump stops on the truck, these internal jounce bumpers will protect the airbags themselves from being over-compressed. And they'll be mated with the excellent wireless air 72000 series onboard air compressor system. This will allow me to control the air pressure in each airbag separately, anywhere from 5 psi right on up to 100 psi, and it just gives me a lot of control over how much air to put in the airbags depending on what load I'm going to run.
Start any good project by putting a sticker on the toolbox.
There we go. Perfect. Finger tight plus 1.5 turns. Looks like that's 1/2 inch. There's 1.5. Goes on one side and the other. 20 pound feet. Torque them. Okay. Okay, a lot of carriage bolts. And then the spring, flip it over, conical nuts on there. Okay, this is a lower bracket cup. This is the lower bracket main plate, and the cup gets installed just finger tight into the lower bracket main plate with a washer and a lock nut on the other side. Leave it finger tight so it can move. I did the other one while you weren't looking, so we're ready to go underneath. Jounce bumper comes off. That do it. That was a piece of cake. All right, these little thingies. Just cool. Now what am I gonna do? Oh, great. All right, let's hopefully find that bugger. Hey, there it is. Oh, okay. Woo! Okay, try that again. We got it that time. There we go. Okay, that's in place. You always get good at something by the time you're done with it. All right, top bracket on the passenger side. Give it a bolt. Not so bad. Installing the assemblies, push the lower bracket, it's flush against the leaf spring pack. Alright, let's do that. Take that lower shock bolt off, driver side, spring pack goes in there. Now we're close. Okay, U-bolt around the spring pack block into the upper hole on both sides.
Turner says to get this just snug. There we go. Lower axle tube bracket. Okay, let's snug those up. Washers. Okay, last step's the heat shield for the passenger side airbag. These are not long enough, so you gotta put two of them together. Okay, it's ready to go underneath. Take some of the slack out. Plenty of space, plenty of motion all the way around the airbag. And now it's time to put on the compressor and the wireless controller. The kit is universal and it fits on a lot of different trucks in a lot of different ways. Some folks will install the compressor above the, you know, spare tire. Some will put them in other places in the frame, inside the cab. But I need to get underneath and see what I can find as far as a good place. Okay, with the tire out of the way, there's a ton of places to put this kind of stuff in here. And it looks like just a really awesome spot right here above the tire, spare tire. Here we go. All right, just find those holes. With the compressor mounted, I chose to make my own bracket for the air manifold. And I just cut off a piece of aluminum angle and drilled holes into it, you know, to mount the manifold. And then simply by using the airlift's bracket, I attached my bracket to it, all the while anticipating, you know, that the required vertical alignment of the air filter. That air filter is that black cylinder with a pointy thing on the end that you see here. It has to be perfectly vertical for it to extract water from the air properly. So again, it's just a question of getting that anticipating that orientation when I mount my little bracket to the steel plate above the spare tire. Should be ready to go. Good and sturdy. There we go. There we go. Nice and solid. So the next step is to mount the compressor relay and the compressor ground wire in a place where it'll have a good ground with the truck. So I just drilled another hole in the spare tire plate and used a burring bit in my drill to provide a good surface, you know, metal to metal contact. And Airlift provides a self-tapping screw to make the connection, and it bites good and hard, and it's a good permanent solid solution. Final step is to make the first electrical connection, which is connecting that relay to the manifold. To get to the upfitter wires, gotta first remove this box, just release this tab and pull up on the box.
See if we can do it one-handed. There we go. And then the box comes out of there. Then you can see and get to, finally, the wires that are underneath there. That little bundle of colored wires are all the upfitter switch, you know, the power wires. All the upfitter wires are now out and available. The wire for upfitter number 4 is the gray wire with the brown stripe, and it's already fused and relayed, so all I have to do is just connect the power into that line. So it's a simple thing. Take the blunt end off of that, do our little strip the amount of wire that we need on there. There we go. And then using a heat shrinkable connector, then we can make that connection, crimp it on there. And we'll be good to go. There we go. Good connection. We're on upfitter number 4. Okay. The last electrical connection is the hot wire to the compressor and over to the wire that's provided on the wiring harness. So the first air hose connection goes from the flexible compressor hose to the filter on the manifold. Airlift requires that there be 2.5 feet of distance between the two, so I just use a section of tubing and coiled it away above the manifold. Then you make the connection into the manifold. Okay, I'm going to run this air hose now down to the passenger side airbag, but there's all that exhaust that runs really close to the airbag, so airlift gives you this little piece of heat protector tape, which is actually very similar to the tape that Ford provides in its texture and material to protect the other electrical line that comes along the back. So you definitely want to use it in the closest place that it gets to that hot exhaust pipe. Passenger side connection. No. Good and solid. Driver side connection. Driver side manifold. There we go. Okay, now we'll tie up all the tubes. So at the end of the day, this is the entire reason why I have the airbags in the first place, which is to be able to re-level the truck when it has a big load on the back end. Notice the back before and after the airbags are inflated. And it's easy to see the contrast between the uninflated, saggy rear end versus the inflated, leveled rear end, which levels not only the truck, but the trailer and all that together, providing a stronger, more stable ride for while I'm pulling the trailer down the road.